Hey there, everybody. Oh, I guess I can take my mask off. Let's see, I can take this off. This is my mask. So, don't need that on, right? Who needs to wear a mask when they're home alone? So, this is my little mask. It's a scarf. You like it? Hey, Teddy. Thanks for hopping on here. So, today I wanted to share with you guys a little something that, I put together. So I listened to all these different people. Alina, I got Tony Robbins, I've got Dean Graviosi, KK, I've got all these people I'm listening to. And I put together a whole bunch of stuff and then a whole bunch of other women too. So this Stacy Martino and Danielle Delgado, I listened to all these people and I listened to their wisdom, things they've connected the dots on. So I came up with this the other day. And I was thinking through childhood, how we grow up as babies. We're born into this earth, not knowing only but two fears, and that was the fear of falling and the fear of a loud sound. And then all the rest of our lives, we create all these other fears. But hey, Shan, hey, Peter. So what I noticed was, as I'm connecting the dots, is as we're very young, we have all these wants and needs. So the five basic needs or seven basic needs with Maslow, whatever. So we can go through those, but it's basically wants and needs in our life. So as a baby, we want and need. So we get all that stuff for us. As we get a little bit older and we get all of our wants and needs met, now we have expectations. So once we start expecting our parents to do all that work for us or expecting them to have a safe house for us, all that stuff comes up with expectations. So sometimes as we get older in adulthood, we have a lot of expectations for other people. But what we find out is when we expect all these things from other people, sometimes it leaves us a little bit saddened. So I expect my man to do those things for me. I expect him to understand me. I expect, I want, I need. And at the end of the day, I end up kind of in an unhappy space because he's not going to give me exactly what I need. Only God can do that. And I'm looking for another man or woman or human to give me exactly what I need. I'm looking for my kids. I expect them to do this. I'm not saying ignore all that, but I'm just saying look at where that's leading us. So once we get through the expectation, and that, you know, is the very young years, then we start working from teenage up into high school and sometimes college, we start building boundaries. So boundaries are good. We need boundaries. That's true. So we start having these boundaries and learning. So this is like the first half of our life is we're learning all these things. We need all that there. We need wants and needs there. We need expectations there. We need boundaries there. We need that through the whole growth of our life. But as we get older, if we're still focusing on those boundaries and people are overpowering our boundaries and we have to make decisions based on that, sometimes, again, that's going to leave us saddened or unhappy in certain ways. So once we come to the next level, I was connecting the dots and it comes to standards. So I kept having boundaries, but people kept steamrolling my boundaries. And then I was upset and I was like, why are they steamrolling my boundaries? Well, because of my standards. My standard was I hung out with those type of people. I hung out with people who gossiped and did some things that broke my boundaries that I didn't want to belong with, but I was there because I didn't have my standards correctly lined up with me. So now, once we figure out our standards, which usually, you know, you start operating in your standards college and, you know, all the years after. Once you've got your standards figured out, and you're sticking to your standards and your values and your principles, just like in the Bible, based upon principalities. So once you've got that stuck in you and it becomes a desire. So when you look at poor people, they want and need money, but guess what? Money never shows up for them because they don't have the desire. Desire, when you have that imagination, you have that plan, you have the desire, you have the action, it cancels out all that other stuff. Not cancels it out, but it trumps it all. So once you have that desire, now your standards and your principles and your values are all lined up. You don't need to expect anything from anyone. You only expect it from yourself. based on your values, based on your principles, which you visualize what you wanted, you had a desire to go after it, whether it's a relationship, whether it's a new career, whether it's you want to do your job from home, you want to travel the world, whatever it is. Hey, Kevin, how are you? I haven't seen you in a while. Aw. Hey, Timothy. Hey, Annette. Hope you guys are doing well and you're happy and you're safe and healthy. So whether it's visualizing your health plan or you want to work out or, you know, it could be anything. So, but that comes with desire. So that desire is something inside you. It's burning inside you, something you want to do. And you have to plan and you have to act it out. That trumps all of the wants and needs and expectation and boundaries and standards. That's where you leave yourself. And that's where the life gets really, really good and you live on purpose. And you go for it and you just gun for it. And hey, Jim. Hey, Micah. Hey, Kelly. How are you guys? Hey, Larry. Glad you guys can hop on here. So I don't know. I just wanted to share that with you guys today and just give you a little piece of something that connected for me. And I love it. It's like, it's life. So we start out life, you know, going through all this journey. My journey's different than your journey. I can't have someone else's journey and you can't have my journey. But we're on here together. So focus on what you guys really, really want. Your desires. Where is it? Come up with a plan. That's what God gave us, is a plan so that we can work on the things. He gave us a will. He didn't say he's going to do it for us. He knows the plan. We just have to act it and we have to do the plan. And we will be greatly, greatly affected in our life and have a wonderful life. But yes, so I hope you guys have a great day. We got two really warm Michigan days today, two out of the whole year. No, I'm just teasing. So anyways, we'll see you guys soon. Bye-bye.